गुड मॉर्निंग एवरीवन।
मॉर्निंग।
सो बिफोर वी स्टार्ट, आई गिवन यू टू प्रॉब्लम्स यस्टरडे। कैन यू टेल मी द आंसर्स वेदर यू हैव सॉल्व इट? There is some disturbance. Those who have solved, can you please tell me the answers? The first question where, yeah. Kavya, I am not able to hear you because the voice is breaking. Anybody else can give me the answers?
Ma'am, Z naught is 293.402
yeah.
Angle minus
42.53 degrees. 293.39 at an angle 42.53 degrees. Yeah, minus. Okay. Yeah. Then what is propagation constant?
Alpha is propagation constant is 0.099 plus 0.09.
J 0.1076. Yeah, that is correct. 0.1027. In that, alpha will be 0.095 meters per meter, and beta will be 0.1027 radian per kilometer. This is also kilometer. What is phase constant? Sorry, phase velocity?
1.1953 into 10 per minus 7.
1.193. Even others have got same answer.
Yes, ma'am. 1.1953 into 10 per minus 7.
You have done the formula as omega by beta, right?
No, ma'am.
1 by square root of LC.
Phase velocity formula Vp, it is actually with respect to beta. You have to do omega by beta. Okay. So if you have done, that's fine. You can take this one also. 5000 by 0.1027, which is equal to 48.68 into 10 to the power minus 3 kilometer per second. What about the next one? Can any others can tell the answers? Others who are in the class, out of 155 plus 50, 105 students. What about the second one? Z naught value?
653.91 angle minus 12.22.
Yeah, 12.985 I have got, that's okay. Next one, what is the propagation constant?
0.0294 plus J77.653.
Is it correct? Others
yes,
are done. Okay. What is J?
77.63.
Okay. This answer you have to check once. I will also check. I have got it as 0.063 plus J0.028. I will also check. You also check once whether I have done wrong or not. I don't know. I have to check the calculations. What about phase velocity? You have done the same formula, I guess.
No, ma'am. 64.37.
Okay. Phase velocity, it is 5000 divided by, if you take 0.028, or else you do with this 77.63. You'll get 178.57 into 10 power 3 kilometer per second. What about lambda? How much you have got? 2 pi by beta?
0.0809.
Okay. Kilometer. This also should be checked. Okay. I hope everybody has solved. So moving on to next topic, we will start with the transmission coefficient derivation. Transmission coefficient. Yesterday you had seen a reflection coefficient. Transmission coefficient, it is represented as T, capital T. Now, yesterday only I told you the definition is that you will have the ratio of transmitted voltage divided by incident voltage. Whereas in case of reflection, it was reflected voltage by incident voltage, or it can be transmitted current divided by incident current. So when we write the equation, it is VTR, transmitted divided by V incident, or it is I transmitted divided by I incident. Now, before we do the derivation, whenever you have the transmission line has to be terminated by a load impedance. The receiving side, what you have, suppose this is a transmission line, this receiving side should be terminated by an impedance, which is ZL. So when you terminate it within a ZL, if it is terminated properly, then you say that it is properly terminated line. So whenever the transmission line is terminated with a ZL, that is load, you say it is properly terminated line, or else you say it as improperly terminated line. Now, according to the principle of the conservation of energy with respect to power, that is incident power. So incident power minus your reflected power. So your sum of the power. So initially you will be giving the power, that is incident power. Sum of the power may be reflected back. That is equal to the transmitted power. So how much power you are getting across the load, that is nothing but the transmitted power subtracting your reflected power. So according to conservation of energy, incident power minus your reflected power is equal to power transmitted across the load. So there is an equation to represent that particular power, that is, or that particular transmission coefficient, which is represented as 1 minus your reflection coefficient square, which is equal to Z naught by ZL divided into T square. We are going to prove it how it is. So 1 minus tau L tau square, or reflection gamma square, which is equal to Z naught by ZL T square. So this is one important equation when you solve the problems. Okay. So where T is the transmission coefficient and gamma L is called as reflection coefficient. Now, there is a figure to note down with respect to power. You can note down those equations and I'll continue with it. And if you have noted down, then just let me know. Done.
One minute.
ठीक है.
Yes, ma'am.
So we will draw the transmitted line so that we will understand what is reflected or what power is transmitted, what power is reflected. So this is the normal transmission line figure which you draw with respect to generator end as well as receiving end. So this is a generator voltage. The impedance across the generator is characteristic impedance Z0. Similarly, to the receiving end, you have load, which is represented as ZL. Now, if I have to write the power, that is your incident power, reflected power, as well as the transmitted power. So this end, which I take, say it is represented as PT, which is transmitted power. Similarly, this transmitted power will be incidented across the receiving side. So this incident power, some of the power will be reflected back, which is P reflected, or we can say to the receiving sending side, it is P reflected or PRS. And the length of the transmission line, as usual, we take it as L. And if it is at the zero point, we consider it as Z. This L will be extended length considered for the receiving as well as sending side. So once again, you have total transmission line with the generator end and the load end. You have transmitted power. This transmitted power is incident to the sending side. Some of the power will be reflected back. That power will be input to your sending side, so which is represented as PRX. Now you have to write the equations for the traveling wave at the receiving end. Now, in terms of voltage, if you are writing, we know incident voltage, we represent it as V plus, which is e to the power minus gamma L. Similarly, reflected power is V minus e to the power, or reflected voltage, e to the power gamma L, which should be equal to, now incident, this will be your incident voltage. This will be your reflected voltage. Incident and reflected both will give you actual transmitted voltage, which I'll be taking it as VTR e to the power minus gamma L. Is it okay with the equation? How do you write? So you need to get a transmitted voltage. For a transmitted voltage, you know, actual transmitted voltage is nothing but the combination of incident and reflected. So combination of your incident and reflected voltage will give you transmitted voltage, which I'll take it as equation one. Similarly, the same equation, if I write in terms of current, it will be V plus e to the power minus gamma L divided by Z naught minus, because it is current, V minus e to the power plus gamma L divided by Z naught. Both are with respect to sending side. So the voltage or the characteristic impedance will be Z naught. Whereas when you come for transmitter side, it is VTR e to the power minus gamma L divided by ZL, because transmitted is with respect to load. So in terms of current, when you're writing, it is V plus e to the power minus gamma L by Z naught minus V minus e to the power gamma L by Z naught, which is equal to VTR e to the power minus gamma L divided by ZL. Make this equation as 2. Write down it. Done with the figure?
Yes, mom.
Shall I continue?
Yes,
tell
ma'am.
me, tell me what is the equation of reflection coefficient in terms of voltage? What is the equation of reflection coefficient? Or tell me what is the general definition of reflection coefficient?
V minus e to the power gamma L.
Gamma L divided
by V plus e to the power minus gamma.
Yeah, it is reflected voltage divided by incident voltage. Now, I'll consider this equation as 3. Okay. Now, we know the main general equation of transmission coefficient. It is transmitted voltage divided by a incident voltage, that is V plus. So, transmitted voltage divided by your incident voltage. Now, this VTR, what I have, that is equation with respect to equation 1. So, I can substitute this equation of VTR in the transmission coefficient equation. So, VTR, if I write from 1, it is V plus e to the power minus gamma L plus V minus e to the power gamma L. And there is one more term divided by e to the power minus gamma L. Whole divided by. Now, I need also an equation for V plus. This V plus equation, for time being, I'll write it here, V plus itself. Now, from equation third, you have to write an equation for V plus. Just bring this denominator to left hand side. So, it is V plus will be there. You have V minus e to the power gamma L divided by tau or gamma L e to the power minus gamma L. So make this equation as this equation. If you make it 4, this you can make it as 5. Just a minute, I'll tell you once again. So first, write down the reflection coefficient equation. After writing the reflection coefficient equation, write down what is transmission coefficient definition. It is VTR, that is transmitted voltage divided by incident voltage. So that is VTR divided by V plus. Now, from equation 1, you can write down what is VTR. So, here in the side, you can write down this particular equation is from equation 1. So, now substitute, then you write down V plus, because you know you don't know what is V plus equation. You can take that equation from equation 3. So, V minus e to the power gamma L divided by e to the power minus gamma L divided by that gamma L. So, substitute now the equation 5 in equation 4. So the equation will be T is equal to V plus e to the power minus gamma L plus V minus e to the power gamma L divided by e to the power minus gamma L. Again, whole divided by the equation number 5. That is V minus e to the power gamma L divided by gamma L into e to the power minus gamma L. This and this will get cancelled. You will have the equation remaining V plus e power minus gamma L plus V minus e to the power gamma L divided by V minus e to the power gamma L. Any confusion?
We have gamma L in the denominator.
Yeah, yeah, in the denominator. Divided by gamma L.
This so we can write that in the numerator, Mama.
You can also write it in the numerator. Just a second, I'll write it down. So, which is divided by V minus e to the power gamma L. This you write it down in the numerator, that is gamma L. Now you can see the denominator is for both the terms, denominator is same. Split the denominator to each term. So you will get it as V plus e to the power minus gamma L divided by V minus e to the power gamma L plus V minus e to the power gamma L divided by V minus e to the power gamma L into this reflection coefficient. Now we need to simplify that equation. So if you simplify that, what will be the first term? V plus e to the power gamma l divided by V minus e to the power gamma l is what? See that equation. Compare that equation with equation number 3, what you have written.
1 by gamma l.
Yeah, because your gamma l is V minus e to the power gamma l divided by V plus e to the power minus gamma l. It is just the reciprocal of this. So I can write it as 1 divided by gamma l plus, this will be 1 into gamma l. Multiply this transmission coefficient inside. It will be 1 plus transmission coefficient l. So this is one equation of your transmission coefficient. That is 1 plus transmission coefficient, sorry, reflection coefficient will give you the transmission coefficient t. So if I write the equation all together, t is equal to 1 plus gamma l or transmission coefficient of one equation. Again, this is important in terms of problems. One more equation you have for transmission coefficient in terms of impedance. What it is? Sorry, reflection coefficient in terms of impedance. Yesterday you have derived it.
ZL minus Z naught divided by ZL plus Z.
ZL plus Z naught. Now, substitute this equation. What was the previous equation number you have written? 5 it is. You can make it as 6. Substitute the 7th equation in 6. Find an equation in terms of impedance for transmission coefficient. Substitute 7 in 6. So that you will get T is equal to 1 plus ZL minus Z naught divided by ZL plus Z naught. Simplify this and tell me the answer. What is the final equation you are getting for transmission coefficient in terms of impedance?
ZL by ZL plus Z naught.
Yeah, it is 2ZL divided by ZL plus Z naught. Again, this is also one important equation what you get. With respect to problems, you have to remember. Don't get confused with reflection and transmission. Reflection will be ZL minus Z naught divided by ZL plus Z naught. Transmission will be 2ZL divided by ZL plus Z naught. You have copied it down. I'll clear the screen. So moving on to, you have to now find out, or you have to derive the equation, that is the one which we have written for energy conservation. That is, the equation is 1 minus reflection coefficient square, which is equal to Z naught by ZL T square. So according to that conservation of power, power carried by two waves, that is, one is incident wave and one more is reflected wave. We know that it is power carried, which shall be represented as input power carried as INR. So I can write it as power carried with respect to input is incident power minus your reflected power. So if you are writing for incident power, tell me what is the equation of power in terms of RMS voltage. General equation of power in terms of RMS voltage.
I square R.
Yeah, it is in terms of current. Tell me in terms of voltage.
Vrm square divided by R.
Okay. It is actually, you, if you are writing in terms of RMS, it is divided by root 2. Vrms divided by root 2 whole square into or divided by R. V square by R is actually the power we write. But since you are writing in terms of RMS voltage, power, it is Vrms by root 2 whole square divided by R. Since here you are considering it as impedance and write it in terms of Z. Similarly, this general equation of power has to be written in terms of power in case of transmission line. Now, incident power which you have taken here is V plus e to the power gamma L. So, if I write in terms of gamma L, the equation, that is e to the power.
Excuse me, ma'am.
Yeah.
The power, the general equation for power goes as Vrms is equal to Vm by root 2, no, ma'am. Not the Vrms divided by.
Sorry. It is actually Vrms voltage is represented as V by root 2. So if you are writing it here, it should be V by root 2 RMS voltage. Don't write RMS here. So it will be V by root 2 square. So if you are writing it here in terms of voltage, that is your incident power. You know the incident power is V plus e to the power minus gamma L. If I apply the same equation here, it is root 2 whole square divided by Z naught. Similarly, reflected power, what you have is V minus e to the power gamma L divided by root 2 whole square 1 by Z naught. Now you need to simplify this equation. So that is V plus e to the power minus gamma L square divided by 2 Z naught minus V minus e to the power gamma L whole square divided by 2 Z naught. So this is the power carried across your transmission line or power carried by your two waves, that is incident as well as reflected. Now this power carried across the incident and voltage, you have to, or it has to be equal to the transmitted power, that is PTR. So first you have to find out what is PTR equation or transmitted power equation. Transmitted voltage, we have taken it as VTR, e to the power minus gamma L. This equation, I'm writing it from the first equation which you have written, V plus e to the power minus gamma L plus V minus e to the power gamma L, which is equal to VTR e to the power minus gamma L. This both will be your incident power. This is reflected power. This is transmitted power. So these are the two powers which are written here. And this power is for your transmitted power. Now this is with respect to ZL. So since transmitted is with respect to load, this will be root 2 whole square divided by ZL. So this will be VTR e to the power minus gamma L whole square divided by 2 ZL. So this is, if I take it as equation A and this is equation B. Now you have to compare both the equation so that it has to be equal, because according to conservation of energy, your incident and reflected power should be equal to transmitted power. This is what you have to prove. When you prove that, you have to get that equation which you have written initially. Is there any confusion in writing this? I hope there is nothing. So, note it down.
Wait,
yeah, you write it. Let me know once you complete it. So, first step, what you write there, it is power carried by two waves. In the side of incident as well as reflected wave, which is given as PINR. This notation you can take of your choice. I have taken it as PINR. That is, I have written it as one is P incident, one more is P reflected. A combination of both. So incident minus reflected. Incident is V plus e to the power minus gamma L by root 2 whole square 1 by Z naught. Minus reflected is V minus e to the power gamma L by root 2 whole square 1 by Z naught. Then transmitted power, if you're right, simplify that root 2, write down the equation. Then transmitted power is nothing but VTR e to the power minus gamma L by root 2 whole square 1 by Z L. Done?
Yes, ma'am.
Now next, you have to prove that this PTR, is equal to, or P incident and reflected is equal to your P transmitted, that is PTR. Now, just substitute the equation and try simplifying what equations you get. First equation, what you have is e to the power minus gamma L divided by 2Z naught whole square minus V minus e to the power gamma L whole square divided by 2Z naught, which is equal to VTR e to the power minus gamma L whole square divided by 2ZL. Now, one step which you can do for simplification is divide the whole equation by V plus e to the power minus gamma L whole square. Divide both sides. Divide whole equation by V plus e to the power minus gamma L whole square. So here 2 and this 2 will get cancelled. So you can bring this Z naught to the right hand side. So the whole equation, if I write, it is e to the power minus gamma L whole square minus V plus e to the power gamma L whole square. You are dividing the equation throughout. V plus e to the power minus gamma L whole square, which is equal to Z naught, I have brought this side, divided by, there is one more ZL, VTR e to the power minus gamma L whole square divided by V plus e to the power minus gamma L whole square. Split this numerator and denominator. So first equation, it will be 1 because
mom, V minus mom, e power gamma L whole square.
This is V minus. Split this denominator now. So it will be V plus e to the power minus gamma L whole square divided by, again, V plus e to the power minus gamma L whole square. This and this will get cancelled. Minus V minus e to the power gamma L whole square divided by V plus e to the power minus gamma L square, which is equal to Z naught by ZL. This equation is VTR e to the power minus gamma L whole square divided by V plus e to the power minus gamma L whole square. Now the first equation, what you have, that is 1 minus, what is this? V minus e to the power gamma L divided by V plus e to the power minus gamma L?
Gamma L.
It is reflection coefficient, reflected voltage by incident voltage. So you get square. What is the next equation you have here? VTR e to the power minus gamma L divided by V plus e to the power minus gamma L whole square.
Transmission coefficient.
Okay. This is transmitted by incident. So you can write it as T square. So the equation what you have to write is in terms of T square. So which will be equal to Z del by Z naught into 1 minus gamma L square. Just see the first equation what you have written is matching with this. This is how you prove it. Write down.
It is matching with the previous equation. Now.
Okay, then fine. Copy down. Now this equation, it indicates that your transmitted power is equal to difference between your incident power and your reflected power. Completed. Clear the screen. The next topic, what you have is you have to find out the relationship between transmission coefficient and the reflection coefficient. This you have already done in the derivation, but this will be usually asked for some 5 marks in the examination. So directly, if you want to write, you can prove it like this. So since you have to find out the relationship between the transmission and the reflection coefficient, first write down what is reflection coefficient equation in terms of impedance. That is Z del minus Z naught divided by Z del plus Z naught. For this equation, add 1 on both sides of the equation. Add 1 to both sides of the equation. So this will be 1 plus gamma L, which is equal to 1 plus Z del minus Z naught divided by Z del plus Z naught. Try to solve this equation. This 1 and 1, sorry. You find out the equation in terms of gamma L. Just simplify the right hand side equation. If you simplify it, it will be Z del plus Z naught plus Z del minus Z naught divided by Z del plus Z naught. So here Z naught and Z naught will get cancelled. So you'll be left out with 1 plus gamma L, which is equal to 2 Z L divided by Z L plus Z naught. But you know that the transmission line equation is also equal to 2 Z L by Z naught, which is also equal to T. So 1 plus gamma L is equal to T. Very simple. It's a simplification. Done. Take down a problem based on this reflection coefficient and transmission coefficient. A certain transmission line has a characteristic impedance 75 plus j 0.01 ohm and is terminated by a load impedance and is terminated in a load impedance of 70 plus j 50 ohm, 70 plus j 50 ohm, compute the reflection coefficient, second, transmission coefficient, third, verify the relationship, that is T square is equal to Z del minus Z naught 1 minus gamma L square, that is reflection coefficient square. Fourth, transmission coefficient equals the algebraic sum of 1 plus the reflection coefficient. A certain transmission line has a characteristic impedance of 75 plus J.01 ohm and is terminated in a load impedance of 70 plus J.50 ohm. Compute the reflection coefficient, second transmission coefficient. Third, you have to verify the relationship. T square is equal to ZL by Z naught into 1 minus reflection coefficient square. Fourth, transmission coefficient equals the algebraic sum of 1 plus the reflection coefficient. I think the first problem with respect to reflection coefficient, you have already done yesterday. Just make a check on it. Same question I have given you to find out what is reflection coefficient. Correct?
Yes, ma'am.
So yeah, I think you have got the answer 0.08 plus J.32. The same step it is. You can move to the second one. Write down the answer or you can copy down later. Find out what is transmission coefficient, the second one. The formula which you have to use. Which is the formula for transmission coefficient which you have to use?
2ZL divided by ZL plus.
2ZL divided by ZL plus Z0. So, substitute it here, that is 2 into 70 plus J50 divided by 75 plus J.01 plus 70 plus J50. Simplify this. First, write it down in A plus JB form. You get 140 plus 100J or J100. This, I think, will give it as 145 plus J50.01. Now, convert it into polar form. What is the numerator just like? What is the numerator value?
172.05 at an angle
35.54. 172.05 at an angle 35.54 degree. Similarly, tell me the numerator. Sorry,
denominator. 153.38
at an angle
19.0. Divide this. Divide 172.05 divided by 153.38. Then subtract the angle 35.54, 19.03.
1.1216.
At an angle
16.508.
Yeah, 16.51 degree. Tell me A plus JB form of this.
1.0754.
Okay, 1.08 plus 0.3187. Everybody are getting this answer?
Yes, ma'am.
After that, the third question what you have is, you have to verify the relationship, that is T square is equal to ZL by Z naught into 1 plus reflection coefficient square. Now, first step, what you do is consider your
ma'am, it is 1 minus gamma L, ma'am.
It's not minus.
Yes, ma'am, it's minus.
Now just take the left, right hand side. First, find out what is reflection coefficient square. That is gamma L. This one. Find out what is the square of this first. That is 0.08 plus J.32 whole square.
Excuse me, ma'am. Is it 1 minus gamma L whole square or 1 minus gamma square, ma'am?
So be 1 minus. Find out the square of this. How much are you getting?
Minus 0.0960 plus 0.0512J.
Minus 0.096 plus, plus or minus?
Plus more.
Plus J?
0.0512.
Okay. Now next step what you have to do is subtract this. That is 1 minus this answer. Find out how much you're getting. 1 minus of that answer. How much it is? Is it 1.0? What is the answer you're getting?
1.096.
1.096.
Minus 0.0512J.
0.0512J. Okay. Now multiply this value with ZL, Z0. 1 minus the square. So the ZL you have is 70 plus J50 divided by 75 plus J.01. Multiply this with 1.096 minus J.0512. After that, find what is t square. Which is equal to the answer of t is 1.08 plus J.32. Find out this square. This both answers should match. What is the answer you're getting here?
1.0572.
1.0572.
Plus 0.68J.
0.6? 8. J. Okay. J. Now check with this whether this answer is matching with this. There will be point difference, no problem. If you have point difference, you can write it in polar form also, this one later. Similarly, find out how much is this 1.08 plus J 0.32.
Ma'am, it's same.
You're getting the same answer. 1.0572 plus J 0.0681. You can write it in polar form also. Once you write it, E plus JD form. Okay. Is that fine for everybody? And clear the screen. The fourth one, what you have, if you see the sentence, it is given that transmission coefficient, that is T, which is equal to algebraic sum of 1 plus reflection coefficient. You have to prove this. It's already written in terms of T and TL, sorry, tau L. So just write down what is 1 plus reflection coefficient. So you have 1 plus reflection coefficient as 0.08 plus J 0.32. Now, if I add this, you'll get it here only directly. 1.08 plus J 0.32, which is also equal to your transmission coefficient. So your RHS and LHS both will be same. Find the solving equation. I want you to solve and come when you come for the next class. That is, Z naught is given as 200 plus J 20 ohm, terminated by a load impedance ZL is equal to 300 plus J 30 ohm. Rest all question are same. Find out what is the reflection coefficient gamma L, find out what is transmission coefficient, find the relationship T square is equal to, that is ZL by Z naught into 1 minus gamma L square, then the last one, that is T, is equal to 1 plus gamma L.